Hi everyone. Today I'm going to show you a really quick trick to make a retractable ride in Open Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. This is a pretty easy trick that abuses the reverse incline shuttle mode to make a coaster train that reverses back to the station no matter how far away from that station it is. A quick shout out to Rofl, who built a very similar ride in their Stage 3 Timeline Park, from which I shamelessly stole my version. Don't know where they got it from, but you gotta give credit somewhere. To demonstrate how this works, we're gonna start by building a very basic layout here with a looping coaster. It's gonna make a little hill down here into an incline and put it into reverse incline launch shuttle mode. Now, since we don't actually have a reverse incline, the coaster is not gonna actually be able to make it through the circuit and is gonna valley here in the middle. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna abuse the way the reverse incline shuttle mode actually works. Once the train hits the back station piece, the train will think that the ride is over and it's gonna try to head back to the front of the station. So what this means is we can delete this piece at the bottom of the valley here, copy the back station piece and paste it in place. We'll move it down to the same height. And when the train starts to valley and hits this back station piece going backwards, it thinks it's at the station and it will want to travel to the front of the station to prepare for the next dispatch. And this will work no matter what pieces we actually have in the station here. So if we put a loop in here before, doesn't matter, we could put anything we want and have our spike, then use the down specter to delete and replace the very bottom of the track. We'll get the same behavior, but we'll have the train going very slowly through this loop, which is, you know, very entertaining. As you can see, even though the train loses so much speed that it normally wouldn't make it through these loops going backwards, because it still thinks it's arriving at the station, it won't go below the minimum speed and will continue on through the layout until it actually gets to the front of the station. Alright, so time to use this trick to make our retractable splash boats ride. I will start by using the water coaster. I'll go ahead and start pretty high off the ground. We want to have a nice big drop down. And then we'll have several of these water pieces here. This will slow the boat down significantly, so that way, you know, it won't fly off the track at the end. Then we're going to put in a plane piece here. This is one that will get deleted later when we copy our station piece there. And just to be super safe, we'll also add a brake at the lowest possible speed and then a gentle slope up, which will reverse the direction of the car. We'll go ahead and change this to reverse incline launched shuttle mode. And now let's use the talent specter to delete this piece of track and copy and paste the back station in its place, making sure to lower it down to ground level here. Lastly, of course, add our entrance and exit. And let's give this a test. So as you can see, the boat gets to the end of the ride, hits the slope, which reverses direction. And now since it's hit that copied station piece, you can see the status is now arriving at station, so it'll travel backwards through the rest of the layout, head back up the hill where it came from until it gets to the front of the station, at which point we can start all over again. And if you happen to care, this ride actually gets surprisingly decent stats. 3.74 excitement is a little bit higher than you would normally think, but I guess, you know, it's got a pretty big drop, so that probably is what accounts for it. The one big issue with this ride is that it has terrible throughput. The coaster boats only hold 6 passengers, and you've got a ride of 44 seconds. So if you do the math, that's fewer than 500 guests per hour, which is pretty sad. So that's just something to keep in mind when putting this ride in your park. Last but not least, it's time to decorate. One extra thing you can do here is to add some little guide rails to the ride here. So the implication is that it's being pulled back up into the station by a cable of some sort. So it might be nice to have just some extra pieces here to pretend to guide it into the station. You could use some single rail coaster here just to add some kind of like walls. Very basic example, but you kind of get the idea. And there you go. Pretty simple trick, but I hope you learned something interesting. And if you have something you'd like to see in the future, let me know in the comments.